headed over to Nick's house right now. We're going to go finally get our tree stand work done today. I think it's like August 30th, which is pretty late for us to get that stuff done. But we got a chance. We got a break in the rain. We're going to be wet and muddy, but it's time to get it done, and we're pretty pumped to go hunt. Really gearing up for elk season in about 3 weeks. We get to go to that, but when we get back, all this will be done, and we'll be able to start hitting the whitetail woods.
Straps are big enough.
We're on our third farm now. I don't know, we probably trimmed 10 or 12 and adjusted two or three sets a little bit. We've got about six to do here. Shouldn't take us an hour. Most of them don't need too much, but there's a little to trim up. So we like to call this place Nunya.
Seem to just love Milo fields in early season.
my first set of the year, so pretty happy with it. It's October 13th, wind is dead calm, so we're hoping we can get away with some stuff in the stand. Just moved it to the corner of this Milo field yesterday, see if I can get close enough to him to get a shot. There's 3 or 4 bucks in here I would shoot. I was hoping some others would be showing up by now, but haven't, and I just want to sit so bad, so we'll, if I get the chance, probably take it, but beautiful night. Both me, Nick, and Matt are all sitting, so should at least see some stuff, see what's happening. Things are starting to change. Scrapes got hit hard this last week. They hadn't hardly been touched. Saw a lot of fresh rubs, so things are starting to happen. Things are starting to change, so we'll just see how tonight goes. Should be a fun sit. In a platform stand right now, we put here about 3 years ago, maybe. Tucked in some cedars, it's really nice, but you can't see farther than 30 yards in here, so a lot of bucks just cruise in this area. Big old thick wooded area we have here in the rut. And if you don't see them coming by, you're never even gonna get a shot, so we're gonna move it a little bit better vantage point. Gonna be kind of a pain in the butt, but hopefully we can find a little bit better set for it. Got the platform moved. We really like this spot. Used to have one near here several years ago, and it was awesome for rut. Could call in bucks like crazy. This place is getting so overgrown though, you don't see near as far as you used to, but this will be a fun place to sit in 3-4 weeks.
Slackers.
It's October 24th. Our first real cold front came in. Coldest it's been so far during the day. Upper 40s or something like that today. So could not go hunting. If I have a chance, I'm gonna go. So everything was good at home. So the wife gave me the thumbs up, and now you're in this Milo field again. This is my third sit in this stand. Seeing bucks, good deer movement every time. So got the wind mostly in my favor. It's kind of marginal if they come from, oh,
southwest of me, but most likely they're gonna come from either out in the Milo, because they bed out there all the time, or back in this bedding to the east of me, so this should be a fun night regardless. I love watching Milo fields early season, and deer movement is really starting to pick up, so I would suspect that we see something good tonight. My brother Matt's out hunting his big one tonight too, so hopefully he'll have a little bit of luck and we'll end the night on a good note, so see what happens.
So
shoebox this early. So I just couldn't pass him up. He's one of those that I'm actually pretty sure he's a 4.5-year-old, but I don't ever see him getting big, real big. And super cool. Don't think he'd bust it off any point. He's got too big to actors. And I was able to get it all on film. That was another one of my goals this year, was to get it on film. And it worked out perfectly. Got a little bit of footage coming in, set the camera, and just waited for him to come in the opening, and took my time, got drawn back, picked my spot, and like I said, I think it's a bump left, but I still think it's gonna be good. So, oh, my wife's gonna be happy. I'm still gonna hunt though. I got buddies coming, and it's gonna be a good time, and we'll find this buck. I just hope he's, dead already. I really think he's double lunged. It's borderline, but just have to wait and see. I decided to blood trail just a little bit, and I was not liking what I was seeing at all. It's very sparse blood and chunks of stuff in there, like food. And I'm like, dang it, this is guts. And I wasn't gonna go much farther. I just thought we'd slip right here just to see what kind of blood we're finding. And his antlers are laying on the ground right up there about 100 yards from us. So I suppose there's no point whispering. His head's on the ground, so I don't think he's waking up.
This buck daggers.
Yeah.
They had these tiny little nubs last year. They looked about like that, and now they grew into that. So me and my son found both of his sheds last year as we were out walking, and we found one from them from the year before, so we found 3 sheds off of them last year. But very pretty buck. Couldn't be more thankful that all this worked out. Placed a good shot, and he was done quick. It just kind of nerve-wracking watching the blood trail, and I don't know what that was about, but I couldn't be happier right now, so be pretty cool. I'd give the brothers a call and start getting this guy taken care of. So.
Another t-shirt inside.
Yeah.
Do you remember when we were looking for antlers last year
and you were riding on my back and we found those big antlers? Those are his antlers. What do you think of that? Dagger. She's excited.
What is that?
What do you think?
Daddy.
What do you think, babe?
Good job, Daddy.
Thanks, bub.
I'm so proud of you.
You're proud of me? Thanks, bub.
Okay.
What do you think? We'll take pictures in the morning.
Yeah.
Hey, babe, you want in?
Got it.